if you look at existing tiger habitats, that is areas where tigers can live, if there was enough prey there, that is much larger than the protected area network that we have.
In some of the issues that have come up in the last 2 or 3 years, when you have a choice of putting a road, a highway, 6-lane highway sometimes, through a wildlife habitat, and there's an alternative, I'm afraid it's the wildlife habitat that loses out every time. That's an attitude and a thinking process that we have to somehow try and change.
If you want tiger populations in a place to survive in a whole landscape, you need to have a network of corridors connecting all these parks, so that if in one forest, because of excessive poaching or because of disease, the population comes down, through natural processes, tigers will disperse and reoccupy that area. So that is why the science of corridor becomes extremely important as we move on, because we are now in a very different situation than how we started 300 years ago.
We really need to focus now on getting communities on board, because I don't think poaching is going to be the big issue of the next decade. It's going to be conflict. It's going to be human-wildlife conflict of every sort.